Yes.
Thank you.
To join the esteemed ranks of the Ski Patrol. Fantastic. Well, you'd better be in peak condition. Now, let's get you some gear. And then we'll review a few simple things you'll need to know. Ski lift operation. The ski lift area is a place where accidents commonly occur. It is the sworn duty of the Ski Patrol to keep this area clear of hazards that may endanger innocent skiers. First-rate job, Cadet! You have thwarted that piece of trash's plans for ruining the fun of some unsuspecting skier. Administering oxygen. At heights above 8,000 feet, oxygen may have to be administered to counter high-altitude sickness. Here are the steps that need to be taken. Step 1, be sure to check the pressure gauge. Step 2, close the regulator flow valve with a right-angled gator clamp. Step 3, open the tank valve slowly to a half turn beyond where the regulator becomes pressurized and there is a maximum reading on the pressure gauge. Step 4, before step 2, add a drop of iodine to the tubing. Step 5, see step 6. Step 6, ignore step 3. Now, you try. Fantastic! Your skills are like a breath of fresh air, or in this case, oxygen. Broken bones. Ah, the broken leg, the ski patrol's cowardly arch enemy. Well, we can fix that in a snap. No pun intended. Perfect! Using sticks and some rope, you can fashion an amazingly secure splint. First, arrange the sticks so they provide support above and below the injury. Now, gently secure the splints with the rope by tying constrictor knots at each end. Make them nice and tight. We don't want that broken leg going anywhere. Take that, broken leg! Now, the patient is ready for evacuation. Patient evacuation. Sometimes it is necessary to get the patient off the mountain as quickly as possible. Ski Patrol candidate, remember your helicopter training? Great! Let's get our patient to safety. Easy now. We must ensure a smooth transfer to the ambulance. Outstanding! Now that's a high we can all enjoy. Chapped lips. Even though the ski patrol can be dangerous, not all situations are life and death. Take chapped lips, for example. Here's what you do. Step 1, remove the cap. Step 2, twist to expose some of the lip balm and apply liberally. Step 3, make the call. Step 37, massage the heart to stimulate the blood flow. Step 38, in the event of 2 or more pints of blood being lost, use blood supply taken from the blood bank. Step 39, make sure you prepare the corpus callosum can be split. You can super glue it back if necessary. Step 128, reapply the cap to the lip balm. Nobody likes dried out lip balm. There, wasn't that easy? Well done, trainee. Congratulations! You are now the ultimate enforcer of ski safety. Take pride in your duty, knowing the slopes are a safer place with you on them. Now go out there and save some lives.
Mm-hmm. Oh!
Thank you.
Thank you. Ah!
So, you want to join the esteemed ranks of...
Don't do it. Ah! Thank you.
fantastic. Well, you'd better be in peak condition. Now, let's get you some gear. And then we'll review a few simple things you'll need to know. Ski lift operation. The ski lift area is a place where accidents commonly occur. It is the sworn duty of the ski patrol to keep this area clear of hazards that may endanger innocent skiers. First-rate job, cadet! You have thwarted that piece of trash's plans for ruining the fun of some unsuspecting skier. Administering oxygen. At heights above 8,000 feet, oxygen may have to be administered to counter high-altitude sickness. Here are the steps that need to be taken. Step 1, be sure to check the pressure gauge. Step 2, close the regulator flow valve with a right-angle gator clamp. Step 3, open the tank valve slowly to a half turn beyond where the regulator becomes pressurized and there is a maximum reading on the pressure gauge. Step 4, before step 2, add a drop of iodine to the tubing. Step 5, see step 6. Step 6, ignore step 3. Now, you try. Fantastic! Your skills are like a breath of fresh air, or in this case, oxygen. Broken bones. Ah, the broken leg, the ski patrol's cowardly arch enemy. Well, we can fix that in a snap. No pun intended. Perfect! Using sticks and some rope, you can fashion an amazingly secure splint. First, arrange the sticks so they provide support above and below the injury. Now, gently secure the splints with the rope by tying constrictor knots at each end. Make them nice and tight. We don't want that broken leg going anywhere. Take that, broken leg! Now, the patient is ready for evacuation. Patient evacuation. Sometimes it is necessary to get the patient off the mountain as quickly as possible. Ski Patrol candidate, remember your helicopter training? Great! Let's get our patient to safety. Easy now. We must ensure a smooth transfer to the ambulance. Outstanding! Now that's a high we can all enjoy. Chapped lips. Even though the ski patrol can be dangerous, not all situations are life and death. Take chapped lips, for example. Here's what you do. Step 1, remove the cap. Step 2, twist to expose some of the lip balm and apply liberally. Step 3, check the call. Step 37, massage the heart to stimulate the blood flow. Step 38, in the event of 2 or more pints of blood being lost, use blood supply taken from the blood bank. Step 39, make sure you prep the corpus close and you can super glue it back if necessary. Step 128, reapply the cap to the lip balm. Nobody likes dried out lip balm. There, wasn't that easy? Well done, trainee. Congratulations! You are now the ultimate enforcer of ski safety. Take pride in your duty, knowing the slopes are a safer place with you on them. Now go out there and save some lives.
Oh, my God. Thank you. Come on.